All right, KJ, I'm excited to have you here. I'm excited to get the chance to talk to you. Look, let's just jump right into it. This 2020 draft, all these wide receivers this year that are coming out, supposed to be maybe one of the strongest drafts that we've ever seen, you know, maybe in the past 20 years in my experience. That's the way I look at it. You had another year of eligibility at Penn State. Why did you decide to come out?
You know, I didn't really expect it at first, but, you know, after talking with my coach, my wide receiver coach, my mother, my father, my mentor, they've been in my corner, so good support system. And you know, they just thought I'm ready for NFL, and I thought I was too. You know, I knew it was a big wide receiver draft class, but, you know, that's just saying, you know, I'm not scared of competition. You know, I've been competing my whole life. I've been an underdog my whole life. So proving people wrong is something that I look forward to doing.
Let's get to the football part of it, because this is where it really gets interesting as far as how people evaluate you. Look, I was in Philadelphia when DeSean Jackson was there. Some people have compared you to Marquise Brown as far as your size and speed combination. How do you assess yourself? What would you tell NFL teams that they would be getting if they drafted KJ Hamler?
NFL teams will for sure be getting a playmaker, you know, despite my size, my stature. And a dog at all times. You know, I think I play with a chip on my shoulder 24/7, and I think my heart is, you know, 6'5 while I'm in a 5'9 frame. So, you know, I just like proving people wrong. You know, my heart bigger than my body. You know, I go out there and compete with anybody. You know, I fear no man. Like my dad always say, they bleed like you bleed. So I want to go to a team that wants me, contribute however I can, you know, and be the playmaker that I can be.
Yeah, look, there's no question that you're a dynamic playmaker. You have game-changing speed. You have the kind of speed that makes defensive backs absolutely sweat playing against you. But let me address this real quick. You know, there's been, you know, there's some concern about the number of drops that you had this year compared to a year ago. What would you attribute that to? I don't see them as a problem. Obviously, I look at them as being correctable issues. But how would you, what would you attribute those drops to this year?
For all the drops that I had this year was mainly, you know, little things like lack of focus or, you know, trying to turn up field and make a play too fast, you know. So I've been working on that this offseason while training for the combine and, you know, looking the ball all the way in through the tuck, getting my hands stronger because I don't think I had bad hands. It was just lack of concentration. And then a lot of times was just having my hand placement. My wide receiver coach at Penn State, Coach Park, always told me keep my hands home. And I noticed that when I didn't keep my hands home and tried to shoot my hands late, I would drop the ball or, you know, something like that, or bobble it.
Awesome. Look, and I know you're close with Miles Sanders, your former teammate, the running back for the Philadelphia Eagles, and your former teammate at Penn State. What has he told you? How has he tried to kind of advise you as you go through this process? And have you talked to him very much about possibly being drafted by the Philadelphia Eagles, considering the fact that maybe you are DeSean Jackson, the second coming?
Yes, sir. You know, I talk to Miles a lot. Miles is one of my best friends. You know, he was my roommate, so living with him was kind of hard. but yeah, we talked about, you know, me playing for the Eagles and, you know, seeing if they're interested or not. So I talked to the Eagles a lot, actually. But, you know, I can only go to one team, you know, and the team that's going to get me is going to get 100%, 120% out of me, you know, 24/7. He said the process is a long process, and due to all these, you know, uncertain circumstances, you know, it's kind of more difficult since you can't, you know, meet with teams like you want to, and it's all virtual on FaceTime and stuff like that. But it's still pretty cool to get to know some of these coaches and know some of these scouts that's talking to you, because, you know, I would have never thought I'd been in this situation I am in like today. So, you know, if I get drafted by the Eagles, I know Sharif Miller, Miles is one of my best friends. So that'd be a blessing. But I think anywhere that any team picks me would be a blessing as well.
Yeah, well, I can assure you when this draft kicks off next week, you won't have to wait very long. Your name will be called fairly early. Look, I appreciate you talking to me. Thank you for coming on, and good luck to you in the future.
Thank you. I appreciate you for having me.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app, and for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.